Hello everyone, hopefully we are live. I am not 100% sure or not yet, but hopefully we are. The YouTube studio, there we go, just was checking out. Welcome guys. This is a very, very early test stream, I guess, which we hope to do probably weekly. We'll do about an hour of fishing once a week in Russian Fishing 4 with my standalone account as opposed to my Steam account, which I normally play on live on Twitch, but I thought we'd try and make some YouTube exclusive sort of content showing, I guess, how you might want to play Russian Fishing 4. If you've got any, don't know exactly how to do stuff, and whatever. We started a brand new account at the start of the year. Haven't actually posted the videos of the first hour or two of gameplay, but look out for that sometime in the near future to go up, if I can find it. And unfortunately I couldn't get it reset, so we're starting from level 8, we're at Winding Rivulet, and we're going to try and catch some fish. It's just gone night, so that does mean that some of the fish we might want to have gone for may not be there. That's right, others might. So this is the cafe, so you just spawn around here. Got the cafe straight ahead, the fish market. This is also where you can sell fish, but if you're wanting to sell fish, if you can fill these cafe orders, they're the best. They'll pay you a lot more silver per fish for the same size, but you have to meet the quantity and the mass requirements for every fish you wish to sell. And up here we've got a field kitchen. Every 1 hour IRL you can come here and get free food. And the tackle store, good place to buy a tackle, which we might need to do stuff because we might do some fishing with our tele sticks here. For, I think we'll do some gudgeon and some bleak first, and but we, since it's night as well, we might get some bream, but probably not quite ready for that. Let's see what we do have. Some maggots and nightcrawler and worm, so hopefully if I go to bait here, we can get some red worms, which are not something we can actually do at the moment. We don't have other... Do I have the map? No, we don't. So the administration on every map is the place where you go to collect a map. They have different prices. This one is 5 silver. Very, very useful. Press the M key to bring it up and it shows you the whole map and the depths of the water approximately in certain spots around along the river here, which is very useful, especially if you're doing float fishing. Knowing how deep the water is always good. Here we've got a farmer's market where you can buy the homemade products feed, which can be a base for ground bait, chicken eggs, potatoes, bacon, and wheat grains. All of these are useful for both eating, and some are useful for bait. So you will definitely want to know about them. The other buildings that are here, we've got the workshop where you come to fix your gear when it's worn out. There's an ATM to buy in-game currency with gold currency, which you can buy for IRL money. Grocery store, which you get ingredients for both eating yourself and turning into some baits. And lastly, we've got the hardware store where you buy useful things like tea kettles for making tea, the this thing, the sphere, I don't know how to say that. Anyway, you need that for coffee. You need a shovel for digging up worms. There's a fillet knife for cutting up fish later on. That's for cooking in. Some of these are for making lures. This one is for making leaders. This one you'll need later for live bait. This one's for making alcohol, grinding up boilies. And scooping up aquatic type grubs. We'll need matches and wood for making a fire later, and other things for making lures and such. But we're going to first attempt, we'll go back to the cafe for a sec. So gudgeon is probably what we'll go for straight away. That's something I know definitely a good spot for. The rest are very hit and miss, especially Donette's Rough. They are super rare, and that would be a trophy size, most certainly. We might be able to catch some zebra mussels. We don't really want to go catching a common carp that big at the moment, but we'll see. So we'll go do some gudgeon fishing with what we've got, and hopefully we catch them. So the little spot is just here, just off the path. We'll use our floats here. We probably want smaller hooks than that, but we don't have smaller hooks. We'll see how we go. Set our float depth to minimum, which is 17 centimeters. Cast as little as we can out, and we'll pop that one down. Oops. Maybe we won't put it down. Normally in this spot you'll catch gudgeon and dace. Normally we would have hooked something by now if we had the right bait. and the right size hook, but we'll see how we go. Oops. Just as soon as I put it down, we fail. Oh dear. Let's try magnet. We might be catching a lot of perch here, we'll see. No, it's a chub. And we're going to get a perch. Let's put it down on this side, I think. Give us more room to play. As quick as we are, we can't do both. That's all right. We might try, if we're just going to keep getting perch and chub on this worm swap too. The maggot. And we got a dace. Which is good. Unfortunately, it was not a tag one there. Tag being anything that's got a green tick, which none of these do at the moment. We might actually even want to move over a bit more. See, let's perch on both of these lines. I think there's a common roach on this line. Oh, trying to get on that one anyway. I think, yep. We lost whatever was interested there. Oh, it's all good. I think. Maybe not, but. Float fishing is not a guaranteed catching method. Not that spinning or feeder fishing is either, feeder bottom type fishing. Hey, we got a gudgeon. And a good size one, too. And that's a half decent roach. And we've got a perch. Oops. So that thing that came up before... telescopic, where... Catching fish with different baits and... Those sort of little qualification things for badges. Catch certain fish with certain under certain criteria. Oh, missed him. I might grab my job. Chub are a interesting fish. They actually fight pretty hard for... And you can catch them. Definitely all three. Oops. Types of fishing. They fight good, but can also be quite a, even to some extent on super light gear, quite a handful. Oh, we didn't cook him. Oops, wrong one. And these fish, if you don't hook them within about a minute, sometimes a second or so, it too late. I don't know if I've got a small hook. Nah, they're all 14s. Ideally, I'm wanting size 20 hooks, probably. For some of these fish, there. The tiny ones that we're actually after have tiny mouths. We're waiting for this float. Oh, no, we didn't hook him. Now we'll pick up the feeder. If you're feeder and float fishing, always, always wait for your float first. Because you can easily lose a float one. You're almost never going to lose your fish on your feeder rod. Excuse me while I grab a drink. float fishing also, in general, actually works better when the float is drifting with the current. So there's a little gudgeon looking at this one. Oh, and we missed him. So it's often better to keep your floats in a sort of a, I guess, production line in some ways. Decent brooch there. Nope. I think we might try some other fishing types. Here goes. Just not quite catching the fish I'm trying to target because we don't really have the hooks. Maybe if I just go and buy some, we might be alright. Alright. If you don't have the right gear, you're not going to catch the right fish. Can keep going. Let's see, hooks. Classic hooks. Yeah, we'll just get some of the really cheap ones. Well, size 18 is better than... Let's try two of the 20s. So we've got lots of time, and still lots of time. Most excellent. So let's go down to size 20 and see what happens. I'm hopeful more gudgeon might bite, but and we'll downsize this one as well to an 18. That would be perfect. Another roach. A relatively large one for the gear we're using. We might run back and buy some other baits too. If we had red worm, we would be having more success, I think. But with the fish that we're targeting, that is. This is a gudgeon day spot. Still no tag dice. Ding. Level 9. Half-ish decent perch. I wonder if I try some wet bread, what will we catch? If anything. Don't remember if there was Crucian and Gibble here. They are the main two fish that will go for the wet bread. Hey, there we go. Second gudgeon. So in one more level, no, not one more level, in three more levels, we can go to Oldberg. This is where we definitely are trying to aim for. That is a roach, and he's looked and then ran away. Oops. And I messed that up. I thought I'd seen the float go under the water. at that. Where is it? There he is. Cool, we got a rough. We need a couple of those. That's a good tip of muscle. That might be a cafe order one, which is weird. Not quite the big one though. That one's, I think, expecting a trophy, which this is a good spot for catching trophy zebra mussels. Nearly time for going for bream, I think. Which way shall we go for the bream? I don't know. Oops. Oh, I missed that one. Oh well, that's all good. I might probably pack these guys up. Go sell some stuff. Go make some stuff. Try a different spot. That spot was pretty good, but let's see, 4 that size, 7.6 silver. Beautiful. We've got 2 gudgeon. We've got 2 days to get that one, so that's good. That zebra mussel we got, 23.07 silver. Very, very, very nice. As for the others, I reckon we got an idea of where I could try for them. Trying to remember where the good not quite available yet. See where we are in our, so potato cubes and wet bread. Bread. Let's make some bait. A lot of useless bait, but that's all right. Recipe incomplete. I can also spend some money on some potatoes. Well, let's make some potato anyway. Oh, we used it all up. When we can make pearl barley, that would be useful. Let's see, if I press the O, bring up this one. And we might want to grab a shovel, I think. Pearl 20. Let's go grab ourselves a shovel. I think we should be able to make that. Does use up nearly all of our silver, but that's okay. And we use up all of our energy. But we did get a red worm, which is extremely useful to have. But now we have no energy. That's okay. We can live with that. What was I looking for? So there wasn't a Ruffy still. So I think we'll keep that one. Keep that one. And... that's all we need to keep, isn't it? Yep, so another 13 silver. It all adds up. Handy tip. Carrots are great for... if you do kind of want energy, carrots are good. They don't give you comfort though, so you really need to come here to the field kitchen to fill up your energy bar properly. Might try the bream at my old favorite spot. Let's go grab while we're here. Some matches. Firewood. So just here is the campsite. This is where you can cook stuff. You have to start a fire and have matches and firewood. And you can cook stuff. Here we've got the brazier, which you can make shish kebabs, baked apples and salmon steaks. Assuming you had any of those ingredients. Smoked bream, smoked catfish, smoked salmon, and smoked Xander in the smokehouse. And we've got fish dryer, which we can make dried roach. Which I probably should have done that, shouldn't I? Oh well, next time. So about here used to be a favorite spot of mine for a while. Just go max cast, in this case not very much because we have no energy because we're in the rain. And we'll just see what we catch. So we might bring it in. We might be able to get it a tiny bit further. So we're actually up to about our hour, guys, too. So I plan on keeping these not much more than 90 minutes. We'll finish fishing probably We'll go till 6 or 7 a.m. I think, and see how we go. We may as well chuck out a float and see what happens, but float fishing normally at night is never a particularly productive, but we'll see how we go. Don't think we're even would be far enough out to be the second deep water. But around here used to be pretty good for bream and white bream. You can catch catfish in here, some burbot. Yeah, pretty much those. Let's try adding make it at least a meter deep. I think a meter deep is probably reasonable. Maybe I should move this one over a bit too. We have a fish on, and we didn't even know it. How about that? New record cast, whole 16 meters. Amazing. And even more, we gained an extra half a meter again. I am too eager. Because our other bait options. Oh, actually, we've got garlic dough. Why am I using a worm? Silly me. We're trying to catch. We're trying to catch bream with a worm, which. You will definitely catch quite a few bream with worms, but you'll catch more with garlic dough or cottage cheese dough or pea porridge. And this spot used to have, about a year ago, was when on my main I got my first and actually only trophy bream. But I actually got it then on Redworm, which is it's not actually that much smaller than some of these. It was 5.4 or something. That song sounds quite flat. Hello. This spot does not seem very productive at the moment. A very interested. That perch seemed very interested. For the bream, one bite seems a bit small though. We'll see if there definitely is no fish on there. I think the last thing we'll do while we're here on our stream for today, we might quickly go over and fish from around here for a couple of minutes. Show you some spots that at least have in the past worked for me. Whether or not they work now is hard to say. That is the beauty of this game, and I guess the frustration as well, that sometimes you'll get spots that work every day no matter what. Others might work for a month and then not for maybe 2 months. So just bleak. Freshwater crayfish and gudgeon. See what baits we can catch, we can actually use, because that's going to affect what we can. We can try catching bleak on horsefly. We can bleak seeds. Oh, we don't have enough coins for. Should have got some blood worms. Go grab some blood worms. What are we looking for? Bait. The blood worm actually might be alright. We might come back here. Briefly at least. We'll see if we can catch a gudgeon or two with either the horsefly or the probably stay here till noon. Also, guys, I do suggest joining a group if you can. A channel group. They're good for sharing spots and handy hints. That one might be a gudgeon or a dace. That's what we're looking for. We can get a few more gudgeon quickly. That would be very, very useful. We can move on and try and catch some bleak in a different spot. Go to Blake. Gudgeon. It did not hook. Whoa. That dude was fighting very hard for 200 grams. It's a dace. Perch. One, two, three, four, catch him. Thank you. Dace, probably. Oh. Good gen, that's all we need. Actually, we'll keep that. And one more for good luck. Very nice. So as you guys hopefully can see, there's a lot of back and forth. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 14 silver, very very good. Our Blake is big enough, this is good. Good, good, good. So we might grab ourselves another bloodworm lot, because we're gonna have to try and catch Bleak with bloodworm, which sort of works sometimes, not always. Everything but the Bleak can go. Another 3.4 silver. All adds up. Never chuck a fish back. Well, at least not until he gets big enough that it actually makes sense to chuck him back. So down here, guys, just to the pond here, where the water is a lot more still. This is a bleak spot. Around sort of this area. So just mostly as far as you can get them out. Ideally, if you have flies, then we might We might try the force fly. Haven't had lots of luck trying to catch leak on them, but how ever did it get over there? Yeah, that should be not too bad. Can't see it here. Good spot. And of course we catch a roach, just that. Can't see there. Try getting a bit closer and that's a good cast. Is that a tench? There you go, we've got a tench. Nice. Try some more about 10. If we haven't caught a bleak by 4 p.m. I think we'll have to give it another day. Try just the wet bread. Do they know you got the tails? Yes, we got it, Blake. One, two, three, four. Alright, let's swap back to the hornmeal. It's a roach. Ideally, you don't want to be standing in the water, but maybe I should just cast it a bit more straight out there and I don't have to worry. I just can't see it around the leaves. One, two, three, four, five flakes that are all 20 grams. Sounds good to me. Let's grab. I think we've probably got our cables as well. Five blink. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 19.9 silver. Excellent. Oh, we had 5 perch. Order. Oh, we needed 4 gibbles. Well, I'm sure we could do both. Super quick. I think we'll just call our stream here for now. Thank you very much for watching, guys, the video. Hope you enjoyed what you saw. I do stream. I plan on doing one of these every week, approximately on a Saturday afternoon for me, around the time that this one was released, which is somewhere between 2 and 3 p.m. Australian Central Standard Time, which you'll have to adjust. And if not, feel free to catch me on Twitch in about 2.5 to 3 hours from now, when we will go for some bigger fish. Like and subscribe, and don't try if you want any comments, suggestions, questions, feel free to ask them. We'll be trying to get back to you as quick as we can, I guess. But otherwise, thank you very much for watching. I do hope that this has worked, and hope everybody has a great day. Bye.